big fun. Do you pledge to boogie with the party of your choice? I plan to make you boogie woogie with my voice.
You pledge to boogie with the party of your choice.
Objected to get up onto the one and to witness party, everybody has begun.
You're meant to boogie with the party of your choice. I'm meant to boogie with the party of your voice.
I heard that, I heard that.
It's everybody number one. This ticket's on the one.
After a while, there was a pause in the conversation. And someone said to David Tudor, why don't you join the party? Ernst answered. He didn't recognize my voice. Finally, he said, are you thirsty? I said, yes. He said, well, come over tomorrow for cocktails. I went back to Xenia and told her what had happened. Xenia told me once that when she
in Alaska,
that when she Alaska. She and her friends had a club. And there was only one rule. No silliness.
Under you. Number 35, under S.
Scratched his pants, lit up the unused half of a dollar cigar, took a puff. Ain't this pretty up
here? Here's the magic.
I says, Earl, this hill can spill us. You better slow down, you gon' kill us. Just make one mistake and it's the pearly gates for them 85 crates of USDA approved cluckers. You wanna hit second?
Wolf Creek Pathway up on the Great Divide, trucking on down the other side.
Well, Earl.
If I could, I'd like to
Wessner! Hands up who wants snow, Wessner! Hands up who wants to die!
She said she'd never hurt me, but then she turned around and broke my heart. The way it hurts.
Keeps me hanging around. She needs someone. of the homeliest women I have ever seen in all my life. I finally asked the superintendent of the hospital why I ever hired two women like this. Said we did it purposely. We didn't want any old guys flirting with them. I don't think anyone did in all the years I was in Leavenworth. But this young fella corrected himself and started again. This time he started by saying, friends and fellow citizens. Well, I guess that's a little better, but there's still something wrong with that due to the fact that your citizenship is in jeopardy when you're housed in prison. None of us could vote. And by the way, we had some big people there. We had both parties represented pretty well. We had Boss Pendergrass, whose money and influence is supposed to have taken young Harry Truman out of the haberdasher store there in Kansas City and carried him all the way up the political ladder to the White House. I see Boss Pendergrass, but he couldn't vote any quicker than Jack Brown. And that's just the Democratic side. We had some Republicans there, too, I'll tell you. One of them was an absent-minded Republican from New York, Waxy Gordon, who had forgotten to pay his income tax on $40 million. So he was absent-minded, but...
No time at all. Time at all. No time at all. You'll be playing all of your favorite tunes like some of these.
Across.